Yes, Mr. Chameleon.
You know why I call you that?
Do I change colors? Oh, yeah, I've come in different colors all the time.
Wow. Well, apart from your physical attributes, we're talking about the kind of roles you've been playing now. I mean, we've seen you play the lover boy role, we've seen you do the action guy role, and now you're doing biopics. As in, is this intentional? Is this what you've always set out?
No, what I've set out to do is follow my heart and allow Grace lead, basically. So the biopic is, it's like one of the most interesting spaces I've been in my imagine. Career. It's like nothing before. I mean, of course, about a massive portrait of a general, about Bangida. Bro, that took all of me as an actor. The shoot notice came quite sudden, even though I had been told yes.
You know, I want to see your eyes while you say these things. it almost feels like you're hiding behind these glasses. This is serious.
We hide behind to see how his glasses.
Yes. So, swagger.
I got notified after the director conceived the idea to make a biopic on that. He said, I came to mind, but then he had to go through certain hurdles to be sure it was okay to use someone, you know, from our part.
Was it Obi?
We crossed that hurdle as well. I was getting ready to get in on set for Living in Bondage, the sequel, you know, at the same time, and this was clashing with that, but then somehow
They
came together, production both came together. If I had said, look, Living in Bondage, this biopic is everything I've been waiting for, but I love this, I've been waiting for this too.
Yeah.
But the book director said, no, you know, we can make it work. And of course, because I had to lose my facial hair for one, the biopic, so it was kind of like a conflict. And I had to study his accent again within that short time.
You also transformed?
Oh, yes, I did. Oh, totally. I had to sound like him as much as I could.
Okay, so give me a taste of what that accent sounds like. Like, if I were to ask IBB now, I say, so what was it like making the most important decision you've ever had to make? What would he say?
It was a struggle from the beginning, but we thank Allah. Allah made everything happen in his own time.
Nice!
You know, I thought I lost it because he was like, boom, boom for film, boom, boom, out, because I had to get back into character to finish
in
it.
Bonded,
you know, but then it's coming back, which is...
You seem to be resonating well amongst the ladies. You know, there was once upon a time you made the hottest bachelor's list. You know, they say you are fine, you are hardworking, you are uber talented, and you know, you are a heartthrob. I know when blood is rushing, you rush to the
different. Yeah. You sound like you're very familiar with this list that I've been on.
No,
you've been on those lists too, have you? That's a very familiar list. Just calling it.
Is there any hope any of your women out there? What's the 411? Are you dating?
But
are
of
you? Who are you dating?
No, I mean, there's hope. There's hope.
Our maids are marrying.
There's hope for change. There's hope for change of this status. This status must change. Soon you'll hear from me.
Okay, but.